Hey everyone. In this video, we're going to be walking through how to solve for a root of a nonlinear equation using the Secant method in Microsoft Excel. As we went through in a previous video, the Secant method is an open root finding method for nonlinear functions, meaning that we pick two initial x values and iteratively solve for a root from those points. I will leave a link to the video on the theory and procedure behind the Secant method in the description below. Alright, so we are told to solve for the rightmost root of the function f of x is equal to x squared minus 3 through 5 iterations of the Secant method. The Secant method is relatively easy to implement into Microsoft Excel. Let's begin by creating a simple row header. We will only need 3 columns here. One for iterations, one for our x values at each iteration, and then one for our functions evaluated at each of those x values. As we need two initial x guesses to begin working with the Secant method, I'm just going to arbitrarily select values of 1 and 3. Now, the only challenging part about Secant method is finding our next iteration's x value. If you recall from our previous video on the theory behind the Secant method, we can use the following formula to easily calculate the x value that we need. After we implement our first iteration of Secant method, we can see that our next value of x is 1.5. Then, we need to find the output that an input of 1.5 gives us, which is minus 0.75. This is actually all we need to complete for the Secant method. We can now drag down these rows here, and each new row generated is actually an iteration. So, after doing that, you can see that after 5 full iterations, we have found the root to be located at 1.7319. According to Desmos here, the actual root is located at 1.732, so very close. So, after only 5 iterations, we are very close to our actual root, which is located between the bounds of 1 and 3. Additionally, in our Excel file here, you can see that if we change the bounds of our initial guess to negative, we can actually find this parabola's other root, which is pretty cool. Lastly, to adjust this Excel file to any problem you wish to solve for using the Secant method, all you really need to do is adjust the function in the column D here for the first iteration and the bounds of the initial x guesses, and that is really all. I hope this video helped your understanding of how you can implement the Secant method into Microsoft Excel. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking the join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.